Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. So on today's feature, what I thought I'd do is guide you through my different GTD inboxes. Now, I've been utilizing the getting things done method by David Allen for a while now, and whilst I don't, I guess, follow it pretty to the point, I actually use it and sort of use the aspects of it, like inboxes, you know, the 2-minute rule. There's actually a video we did about the 5 key takeaways that I found valuable from it that might be helpful. But what I want to do today is focus in on how they interact with the applications I use. So I'm going to talk about the likes of Notion, Evernote, Todoist, and even some of the different locations I have inside those applications, and reducing inboxes as well as physical inboxes too. Before we dive into this video, guys, you can check out Woven. It's a sponsor. I wanted to do a short introduction to it, so here's a little bit about its features. So guys, this month's sponsor is Woven. Now, Woven is a all-in-one calendar with powerful scheduling tools. Now, I discovered it back in November last year, and I've been using it for the last 3 months to manage my podcast meetings, festive plans, and much more. Now, Woven builds on existing calendar systems and gives you scheduling superpowers. Now, first off, Woven has plenty of scheduling tools baked in. Send scheduling links to book one-to-one meetings with clients. Create group polls to plan an after-work event. Or use smart templates to quickly time block your calendar. Secondly, the powerful Maps feature allows you to plot and plan your commutes, organize where your next meeting is, and get a sense of direction in your day. Quite literally. My favorite feature has to be the scheduling tools. I've been using them for the podcast, arranging meetings, and also collaborations on the YouTube channel, and I've found it really easy to use. The design has to be shouted out too. Woven's attractive desktop app screams easy to use scheduling and helps you to get comfortable with your calendar. And Woven isn't just on desktop. You can get it on web and iOS too, with an Android app on the horizon. Now, I made a bold statement a few months ago, Woven is a new sunrise, and they're heading into a bright future. So try out this powerful calendar application today by visiting woven.com/keepproductive for more details. Thanks to Woven for sponsoring Keep Productive this month. So guys, as you can imagine, I want to set the starting point as Notion, because I think Notion's one of these applications that a lot of people are wondering how people capture stuff into them. And I would say for at least the last 9 months, I've been capturing reading material in the form of articles into Notion. Now, I'm in a bit of a transition phase because I'm actually changing the way that I've set this up, because I want it to be a little bit more fine-tuned. But I very simply use the web clipper whenever I discover an article that I find suitable. Now, the reason I do this is because at the moment it seems to be the best place to actually go in and read or be able to sort of clear stuff. And I sort of want it to be kept in a relatively similar place. So I'm clipping stuff through Notion, mainly articles and useful reading material. Now, the other way that I'm using Notion is really for some of the most recent stuff with the baby. We're obviously planning to have a baby in May, so it's like being able to work out whether we're getting all the stuff together. You know, like all the things we want as well, including like prams and all the sort of buying material. So I'm just literally in the evenings, we'll look at stuff and we'll save it into a database called Everything that we have dedicated for the baby. So we can literally go around that soon and be able to sort of process it and find the stuff we actually want to buy. So there's obviously a few sort of fine-tuning ways, but that's a really simple way of the way that we capture in using GTD inside of Notion. It's not really, I'd say, a very fixed way, because you're not adding like dates and information like that. So again, it's very similar to the way that I'm using Evernote. So in terms of Evernote, I have a main inbox notebook, which is a default notebook. So everything goes into there. And essentially what I'll do is whenever I have a new document, I will literally clip it in there. The other day it was like a TSB bank document, and then there was like a British Gas document. So all these sort of like household documents, health documents, finance documents, etc. And literally just clipping them using the camera application to be able to add into the system. And the goal is not necessarily to sort of sort them straight away. What I try and do is like a monthly process. So I'll dump everything in there because I know that the search is fabulous. And I also know that in the last couple of months, my naming has been pretty well with files. And then what I'll do at the end of the month is sort of process that inbox. So I'll have anywhere between 50 and 60 items in that inbox, which I can then clear out, add into the relevant areas now that they're sort of in there. So I mainly store sort of documents in there, whereas Notion was more like articles, more like web-based stuff. This is more like physical so that I can store it and manage it on the go. So looking at Todoist, I do the majority of my GTD work here. So literally throughout the day, I'm using the feature Quick Add, which is probably the biggest lifesaver. For me, it's Shift-Command-I, I believe I've set it up as. You can change that on the Mac settings, and obviously on desktop. And I literally do that for everything. Like if I have an idea, if I have a thing that I need to buy for the shops, if I'm answering an email, and I'll touch on the email side of stuff and when it comes to tasks. But anything that is just something that's popping into my head, I will just dump it in there for me to process later. Now, task capture is really easy inside of the application. So I'm very simple with it, I guess. So what I'll do is I'll pretty much just add everything to inbox. And if anything is relevant to the week review, I know that I'm going to be looking at it in the next week in terms of like, I guess, a milestone-y thing. Like it could be like, look to reduce the amount of work I'm doing on the podcast. Then I can instantly add it to the week review project so that it's not in my inbox. And the same goes to shopping to some extent. If there's a shopping item that I know that I'm going to be shopping later anyway, like I'm finishing a coffee shop and then going shopping and then going home to do carry on work, then I add it straight to shopping and I know that automatically there's all going to be stuff relevant there. Now, only recently I have looked to add the Todoist Google Assistant on the home. And I must say it's been actually fairly, there's a little bit of a learning curve with it, but I'm actually pretty impressed. You say, okay, Google, I don't want to activate it now. And you literally, say, let me speak to Todoist. And then you're sort of met with the prompts on how to get started. And I am now saying add, X to my list, and it'll go naturally onto the inbox area, which is perfect. So that's really all I need. The goal is to capture stuff without any hands so that I can just be just before bed. If I want to get something out of my mind, then I can just dump it inside of there without having to even go up from my phone, sort of get a little bit of light distraction. So obviously that's how I capture most things throughout my day. I also do this on the go. I'm a massive clipper of things as I'm walking home, whether it's an idea when I'm on a run or in the gym. I will just add it to Todoist inbox. And the 3D touch works really well, actually. If you've got an iPhone that's above 6S, you can push down on the app and actually open up this mini menu, and you can quickly add new items there. So when it comes to emails, emails are fairly easy. Like, for example, what I'll do is I'll go off a system called, it's Merlin Mann's Inbox Zero. So the concept is to get your inbox to zero every time you start processing them. So obviously if there's one or two quick responses, I'll do that then and there. But for example, I'll get that inbox to zero using a multitude of methods, snoozing and things like that. But the concept is really very simple. If I have a task and I get it, so for example, if someone like assigns me a course to develop, then I'm like, okay, there's a task. So I'll quick add that to Todoist. I'll obviously reply if it needs to. And I'll get a next action as well. And then I'll archive that email straight away if I've happily responded to that person. But that's really easy because I just use a command shift I as again to open Todoist and be able to add that in the background. So the good thing is it overlays. You don't have to switch to another application. These keyboard shortcuts can save you tons of time. So that's the way I'm doing it now. And I find it really beneficial. I never really use Quick Add to actually plan tasks in. That's more of a dedicated session on, say, a Wednesday or Thursday. But email inbox is very simply sessions 2 times a day. The goal is to get to inbox zero. I try and clear it in the morning before I start the day, just so that I'm sort of caught up on what's needed. And at the end of the day, best I can. And if I miss any of those, I'll just skip to the next session. I won't necessarily do or add one in, say, the midday. So that's just how I work. Now, there are obviously loads of physical in trays that you'll get during your day. I've talked about having a documents drawer is in the middle drawer of my desk, which is really handy. But the thing that I, you know, typically get is receipts when I go to the shops, paper or post. So whenever post comes in, it goes straight in the in tray, and then I'll do a clear out every single week. And also the same with sort of like stuff that I'll capture. You know, for example, like your bag, you've also got your pockets in your jeans or whatever, your trousers, but you also have your bag. And I have a pocket in my bag that I'll store like anything else that will go there. So I'll make sure I just check those two inboxes in case I picked up a letter, a receipt, a document, or maybe take some notes myself so that I can be able to sort of save them too. I don't really use any notebooks that are specifically for task capture. So I do the majority of my task capture on Todoist. And if I have any sort of project capture, it goes into Notion, but that's all done in contained sort of sessions. So guys, I don't know whether this was interesting to you. I actually was a bit, you know, wondering whether to actually do this video in terms of offering some value, but please do let me know what you think. You know, GTD is a really fixed process, and I really go around the edges with it, so it's not really necessarily pure GTD, but it's something that definitely I can see the framework continuing to assist my life. But yeah, I mean, a big thanks for following this year. This will be a little bit of a break before we start the new year, but I just wanted to say a big thank you, and I really hope you have a marvelous Christmas. Anyway, guys, a big thank you. Talk to you guys very, very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.